Hi, my name is George Cochrane and I'm a sales engineer for Datto. Today, I'll be running through some examples of the Autotask PSA and Datto RMM tools working together to solve some common workflows for IT service providers. So what is a PSA or professional services automation tool? Well, a common situation for IT businesses is that they buy individual tools for individual purposes. Typically, they'll start with a service desk tool, then they might add a remote takeover or RMM tool. To bring on new business, they could then get a sales tool followed by a contract tool to keep track of all the licenses, and then a project tool, and the list goes on. With this kind of setup, you might quickly lose sight of everything you're doing for customers because all of the work is in different places. We find that businesses that follow this kind of practice will be the same ones that suffer the most from clunky processes, bad internal communication, and poor reportability. Unfortunately, the customers notice this too, because they experience a slower response, inaccurate invoices, and less insight into the work you're doing for them. However, the less they understand your value, the more they'll start to consider where else they could be spending their money. So, the Autotask PSA. It's designed as a business management tool for IT services and includes all of the different components I mentioned before and actually some more. The Datto RMM tool allows you to manage your customers' IT estate, including desktops and servers, as well as network equipment such as firewalls, printers, etc. It's been developed alongside the PSA for the last 4 years to make the most seamless and natural integration available today. In this session, I'll take you through a few examples using the two systems together as one platform. So, let's start from a monitoring alert that's coming to the service desk. For many of our partners, actually, the tech team can be some of the best advisors to the customers and the best at getting sales opportunities out. So here you can see my monitoring dashboard, and I've got a range of things coming in from server alerts, devices missing patches. I'm going to start with something simple like a disk usage ticket, and I'll grab the first one on the list. Here we can see that this device has only got 10 gigabytes free, and lots of red on the screen. I know this is something fairly urgent to work on. I've even got the device that had the issue directly linked. I'll come onto that in a moment, but can we see here that there's 69 recent alerts from that device? So let's have a look at what those are. And as a tech, that's shouting to me that this person needs a new laptop. So I might, for example, export this list out of all the alerts that's happened here, send this to the customer, and then make a to-do for the salesperson to follow up and make a quote. So the to-do, you can think of like a sticky note, something to come onto for someone later. I'm going to assign this to one of my salespeople, Steve, and it's going to be a sales request saying, Mark really needs a new laptop. Okay, save and close that. And now on Steve's dashboard, which will be configured much more to show sales metrics, his recent quotes and things, he will see that showing up as something that he's got to get onto later. Okay, I'm going to now take you through a bit of an example of following through that sales cycle. And it can be done pretty succinctly. If I go to the plus, make a new opportunity, it's just the term we use for the anchor point of all the stuff related to that deal. And I've even got a template here for a laptop sale. So most of the details filled out already. Just need to put in who's this for. In this case, it's going to be Oldwick Engineering. It's also going to be projected to finish today, I think. Okay, let's save and open the quote. And it's grabbed all the details ahead of time. So, I need to give it a contact name. This is for Mark, as we said earlier. Okay, so now I have an empty quote, and naturally I want to put in some details. So I'm going to actually import in items from a similar quote I did recently. A little bit blue Peter, here's one I made earlier. And let's choose that one. And we can see a simple upgrade to a Lenovo, a new SSD in there for more storage, and a few extra services that will be billed monthly. Now, once I'm happy with this, I could actually follow through a little wizard to win this quote, or perhaps lose it, because it's also important to track where we might be losing out on certain deals. But let's say one, and by following this wizard, it would actually take all of these items through to billing. It would create a ticket for the technician to go and set that up and actually automate a lot of that sales handover process to the service team, which a lot of people do quite badly, and they admit so themselves. With that, it now comes over to our tech team, who have to go and deliver the laptop. Now we're going to go over to the service team and show an example of what setting up that new device might look like. So if I go up to the icon here and down to the shortcuts, I can click straight into the RMM tool because they have a single sign-on. We were working for our customer Aldwick Engineering, and to add a new device on a one-by-one basis, it can be as simple as just clicking New Device, adding a Windows agent, and run the exe that downloads on the target machine. Now, maybe before I do that, actually, I might want to set up some startup tasks for that machine to do when it first connects to our platform. So I would probably do this for the entire customer. I select all the devices. I schedule a job. I call this first time software, perhaps. I will choose the schedule to be on connect, which means every device that we see in the future will get these tasks run. And I'm going to add maybe one of my groups of the scripts that I've put together, like this new computer prep. And I'll select perhaps these three to run. Okay. So in future, every new device that gets added will have these three bits of software added. And this can include a whole range of things. It can be compliance, it can be new software, etc. So now that we've added a device here, let's go over to the PSA again and see that this device is actually synchronized into the asset list for that same customer. I'm on this account overview page for Aldwick Engineering, and we can see all the recent things going on, recent tickets, contracts that they've got with us, recent devices that have been added. And as you can see in here, we've got them sorted by the host name, we've got the missing patches, even the last logged in user to help us match up the users. Now that's quite a nice thing to do actually, so let's do that next. If we go to the item mapping tool here and go back to Aldwick Engineering, we might imagine that this device here is the new one we've set up for Mark, and I'll select him from the list and also perhaps put it under contract to make sure that they don't get billed extra for this. Okay? As an example of what this will enable you to do, well, first of all, we can make sure that we are not supporting devices that aren't actually supported under contract. We could perhaps set up a workflow rule to notify us when a device is supported that doesn't have a contract on it. But also, because we set up a default user, we can now make a new ticket. So let's do an example for a different company. I'm going to go for the Amsterdam office here. And let's say we are trying to support Joe Sampson here. I can select him as a user, get the quick contact details on the right, but also I can just press this one button and it will actually grab his default device, which in this case is a server. And let's fill out the rest of the ticket with a speed code, which just allows us to do the standard types of problems in a nice, quick, easy way. So let's imagine, okay, for a print problem. And there we go, let's click save. And you can see the device is there on the top right, ready for me to connect to, as well as a checklist of four things we might want to try when we're on there. So with one click, I get my remote connection launched up. And when I'm connected to the device, I've got a whole range of tools to use behind the scenes. So for example, there's the command shell. I can jump on here and do a quick IP config as an example there. Or for a printer problem, let's go to the services. Let's search for the print spooler and let's restart that. Okay, nice and quick. So a lot of technicians at this point are used to the fact that you've now got to write up your notes to prove what you've done. However, because we own both tools here, we can actually carry over information we know from the remote takeover straight into the ticket notes as well. So when I disconnect from this device, you can see that I could add these notes to an existing ticket, like the one I was already working on, or perhaps I jumped straight on to fix the machine. I hadn't even made a ticket yet. So we can be even more thorough in logging everything by making a new ticket from here, You'll see I was on for 45 seconds. I wrote ipconfig in the shell, and also I restarted the print spooler. So it's pretty much an end-to-end flow. You started in the PSA tool, being fed alerts that come in, or picking up the phone, or taking up emails, adding the device in if necessary, jumping on, doing the work, and the notes are already there for me. Perhaps I would just add in a couple more lines to explain what really fixed the problem. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed watching a few examples of the PSA and RMM tools working together, and thank you for listening.